Elyse's talent and beautiful music, but somewhere along the line, Lord, that we would make a connection with you. Would you grant that? We ask you in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Elyse Buehrer.
Constellations, so I thought it was a good transition from that last one. Confession time, I'm not only not good at talking, as you just heard a second ago, but I'm not very good at looking people in the eye. I've never been good at it, especially when I'm up on stage. So I'm just going to be looking back there, and that spot back there is like the symbolic you. So just know that I'm looking at you in my heart. And it's not that I don't love you guys, it's that I love you too much. So if I look at you, I'll be distracted by all the love. So no, I'll try to look at you sometimes. But If I could, though, I would have something, and maybe this is something I could work on for the future. I could have a big screen here, and I'd be kind of like a silhouette. You wouldn't see me too well, and the screen would have images of nature and things like that, and maybe art. And for this next one, I would definitely have stars. So since I don't have that, just picture.
Last time I saw Eden,
take credit for that one either. That's a Randy Stonehill song. It's a really good one. I'm going to read a little passage of scripture that goes along with it. Then the Lord God said, "Behold, the man has become like one of us, to know good and evil. And now, lest he put out his hand and take also the tree of life and eat and live forever." Therefore, the Lord God sent him out of the Garden of Eden to till the ground from which he was taken. So he drove out the man, and he placed cherubim at the east of the Garden of Eden and a flaming sword, which turned every way to guard the way to the tree of life. This is taken partly from Psalm 12. I think you might recognize it.
rise up and defend the poor, for the end is near for us. For the truth has been drowned in lies, and justice has turned to rhetoric, while the fools overwhelm the wise. How much longer will you tolerate all the hate, my God, the suffering? No, the evildoers find they were mistaken when they said God's death, God's mind. When will you indicate that you've seen everything? Well, I await your judgments patiently, but I'll be waiting for eternity, it seems. Help, Lord, for the mighty oppress the meek, and the world is a tyrant's property. Rise up and defend the weak from all of our enemies. Oh, Lord, we're surrounded on every side, and there is no one to deliver us. So why do you hide your face from us?
For the oppression of the poor, and for the sighing of the needy, now I will arise, says the Lord. I will set him in the safety for which he yearns.
Let me see.
copyright book open. I'm sorry. So I'll tell you a little funny story about that song while I'm waiting. So first of all, I just think that's a really good message. He who began a good work in you, because sometimes we just see the beginning and we don't know if anything's going to come of it. And when you look at the scriptures, you can see a very beautiful beginning in Genesis, and then you're not sure what happened to that and what's going to go down eventually. So I just like to think of singing this song not just to an individual, but also to the whole world, to the world itself. He who began a good work in you, planet Earth, will be faithful to complete it. Because in the end, God will redeem the whole world. That's not the funny story, though. The funny story is, I work at Hobby Lobby, and they have a soundtrack going of mostly Christian music, actually, but there are no words. So I know a lot of the songs, but not all of them. And this one was one that I heard there, and I did not know what it was. And I heard it a lot, and it always seemed like I was hearing it when I was having a bad day, or when I was like dealing with something especially annoying. And so I made up my own words to it to reflect my irritation. The words I made up were, well, I'll just sing it for you. Sorry. Hey guys, guess who's at work right now? Turning point is the incarnation of Jesus Christ, and more specifically the crucifixion and the resurrection. And this is a song we sing typically at Christmas, but really kind of goes with any time of year to prepare our hearts for the coming of Jesus, to remember the time he came first, and to look ahead to when he comes again.
Oh,